The service safety restraint system message is an indication that there may be a problem with one or more components of the vehicle's safety restraint system. The safety restraint system, which includes the airbags, seat belts, and other components, is designed to protect the vehicle's occupants in the event of a collision or other impact. The system is monitored by a series of sensors and electronic control modules that communicate with the vehicle's onboard computer system. If there is a problem with any of the components or sensors in the safety restraint system, the onboard computer will detect the issue and trigger the service safety restraint system message to alert the driver that there may be a problem. Let's take a closer look on the causes of this issue and how to fix it. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Bad clock spring. The electrical connection between the steering wheel and the various sensors it uses is maintained by the clock spring. Therefore, the connection is supposed to hold even when you turn the steering wheel in all directions. The clock spring, however, can degrade over time. The service SRS warning light turns on when this occurs. The buttons on the steering wheel might also stop working. Additionally, you might lose the ability to use the horn, which would prevent you from honking at all the crazy drivers. Even scarier is the fact that without the clock spring, the airbag's connection is broken, depriving you of the necessary protection in the event of an accident. When the clock spring malfunctions, additional warning lights may also come on. The traction control light or the check engine light might be present. Just double check that all of the lights are connected to the same fault when you check the codes later in the video. Faulty airbag. Never be left wondering if the airbag is malfunctioning. Modern automobiles have internal sensors that alert you if an airbag starts to malfunction. The airbag's internal mechanisms continuously check on its condition. When an accident occurs, your airbags might not deploy if the airbag is faulty and the warning light illuminates. You should take the warning seriously just because of this. If the Takata airbag recalls apply to your car, it's even more crucial to investigate any defects. Bad airbag sensor. Any abrupt stop of the vehicle that might suggest a collision is taking place is picked up by the airbag sensor. The sensor determines whether the airbag needs to deploy based on the speed at which that stop is occurring and the force of the impact. Typically, the main airbag sensors are located behind the bumper. Only when the warning light illuminates can you tell if the sensor is malfunctioning. Other than the airbag not deploying due to poor communication, there won't be any other symptoms. Faulty seat occupancy sensor. The seat has a sensor that interfaces with the SRS when there is a passenger side airbag present. This sensor informs the computer whether a person is occupying the seat. The system won't activate the airbag during an accident if no one is present. This sensor, though, is not infallible. When it does, you are informed to service the system and the SRS alert is signaled. Wiring issue. An intricate network of wires links every component that we've been talking about. These wires plug into various connectors so that the system as a whole can communicate. Wires naturally deteriorate with time, which causes fraying and damage. Additionally, connectors may corrode or degrade, which most frequently happens when moisture enters the system. The light turns on and the airbags don't deploy if the electrical system that powers them is at fault. Faulty SRS computer. As with most components in modern cars, this entire system is controlled by a computer. Even though these computers are designed to last the lifetime of a vehicle, damage is still possible. The SRS computer may fail early due to corrosion, aging, and excessive vibration. When the computer is finished, a warning light illuminates to notify you of the error. How to fix? When this light turns on, what should you do? Should you take it to a repair shop or try to fix it yourself? You alone can provide an answer to this question. In some ways, repairing the SRS fault is straightforward, especially if you have some mechanical expertise. On the other hand, some parts of the system should only be serviced by certified mechanics. Let's get into more detail about this. To solve the issue, take into account these steps. Scan the codes. The computer has a code set with this SRS light on. If you have a scanner that is compatible, you can read this code. The majority of cheap scanners won't be able to read this system. Make sure you choose a code scanner that can read SRS faults when you buy one. Diagnose the airbag system. Numerous sensors, electrical connections, and a central computer make up the airbag system. Finding the issue when a fault arises can be challenging, particularly if you lack experience. You could get into a lot of trouble trying to figure out the issue without having a thorough understanding of the airbag system. This is why we typically advise skipping ahead to the next step. Contact a professional. Ideally, you already have a reliable mechanic you turn to when a problem arises that is outside the scope of your expertise. If so, get in touch with them right away to set up a meeting. For inexperienced mechanics, this system is too delicate. Be cautious if you visit a new mechanic with whom you are unfamiliar. Selecting a person who is certified and knowledgeable about the airbag system is crucial. Hope the information was useful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.